Hello, and welcome to Savor the Southwest. I'm doing a little quickie here on making cowboy coffee. The spousal unit likes the brew kind, but I like mine thick and rich and chewy. And I do start with filtered water because I like my coffee to not have all sorts of impurities in it. So I just take my 3 tablespoons of coffee and I put it down in the mug. There you go. And I want to share with you this spoon, talking about cowboys. Got this spoon in Mexico in a little market many, many moons ago for about the equivalent of a nickel. And it's a spoon with the Saint Santa Teresa on it. And I just kind of like it. And it fits perfectly in my coffee can. So I always have a spoon there. Anyway. So the water has boiled and then it sits for a minute or two, just like you're doing when you make French press coffee. You don't use actually boiling water. You let it just come a little bit off the boil. And I pour my water in my coffee cup. Now, you know, I only have 1 cup of coffee today, a day, so it's nice and big. And then you stir it in just a little so that you make sure that all the grounds are wet, and then you let it sit for about 2 minutes before you stir it once more, and most of the grounds will just settle right down, and then it's very drinkable. I'll come back with another quick shot. Cowboy coffee. It's been sitting for 2 minutes. All the nice, rich oils and flavors of the coffee grounds has been soaking into the water, hot water. You see that nice foam on top? That's the good stuff. And you know, I realized I should show my mug. It's from Gimli, Manitoba. Not that I've ever been there. They do have cowboys there. They have open range with cattle, where they run cattle, and they do have people riding horses to take care of the cattle. And Gimli, Manitoba, evidently has a large Viking. And so I'm gonna have to go there someday and see that. But the one last thing about my cowboy coffee I'm gonna show you, I'm reeling you up there. There is a cowboy coffee pot, and it's actually sitting next to an old style bread maker, which I use every so often, but I mostly use my hands. That is a nice big pot for making some coffee, and it's a good pot. It just makes a little more than I can drink in one day. So here's my big old cup of coffee, just made nice and rich and thick and ready to be enjoyed this morning as I'm writing my post. And I have to say, I don't know if you can tell, it's a really wide bottom mug, very hard to tip over. And here's the reason we have mugs that don't tip over. Somebody likes to sleep on the desk. He's 15. He's got his little lamp with an incandescent light bulb in it, so it shines on his sore, arthritic shoulders and hips. And he spends a lot of time in the box, and he knows that he has to get in the box when he's misbehaving, you know, like trying to push papers off the table because I haven't been paid attention to him. This is how I savor the Southwest a lot of the time, with my coffee, my cat, and my keyboard. Old-fashioned keyboard, very old-fashioned keyboard. Bought this a long time ago, and there's some type on the computer screen, old Windows 7. Yep, this is pretty much my life for a lot of the time. And then I see something go by outside. Roadrunner, coyote, I had both in the same day. Bunnies, all sorts of stuff, javelina. Ah, yes.